大家好 I'm Nathan Rich, aka 火锅大王 Sorry for my bad lighting. Steven Crowder is a right-wing commentator and comedian. He frequently says so many dumb and misleading things, it's really just insanely easy to debunk him. Still, I do watch his show from time to time, mostly to check in on how him and his followers are viewing things. Recently, Florida Governor DeSantis signed 3 bills into law that are meant to counter Chinese government influence in Florida.Now, if you're wondering what Chinese government influence there is in Florida, you're not the only one. It's highly likely these bills are nothing more than virtue signals designed to show the right just how tough on China Ron DeSantis is. So let's hear what Steven Crowder has to say about them.
On Monday, Governor Ron DeSantis, he signed now into law this legislation banning the... And just to be clear, when people say, stop Asian hate...Stop Chinese hate. That was racism. It's not Asian hate. It's
Chinese hate. Chinese hate.
Stop Chinese hate. Look, no one here hates Chinese people.
Here we go. These people love to explain how they don't hate the people they're attacking. Guys, the right loves Chinese people. That's why they need to attack Chinese people. But we're getting ahead of ourselves. Go on, Stephen.
I do, however, hate the Chinese Communist Party, the government.
You hate the Chinese Communist Party.Or you hate the government. Those are two completely different, unrelated things. You do not need to be in the government to be in the Communist Party of China. So when you say you hate the Chinese Communist Party, what you're saying is that you hate the government of China and around one out of every Chinese person in China. Old ladies on the side of the road helping people with directions. Children trying hard at school and looking for a prestigious future in the party.Those are examples of people you just said that you hate. And if you think those are extreme examples, you're wrong. There are a lot of volunteers, firefighters, doctors, police, soldiers, school teachers, and pet store owners that you just said you hated. Those are the people of China, Stephen, who you clearly do not care about. You hate them. Anyway, you also hate the government. Go on.
The government. And if you are an American, and if you care about the Chinese people, you would be...well advised to hate them also.
You know you're dealing with an intellectual powerhouse when they are literally telling you to hate people. Amazing prescription. But let's let him trap himself in some more lies before we go on. Okay, Stephen, what are these bills all about?
So the bill bans the Communist Party. Some people are trying to frame it as though Chinese people, Chinese Americans, nope. The Chinese Communist government from buying land in the state of Florida.
Wow, okay, that's nice of you to very explicitly go out of your way to clarify for all your viewers. The bill, which is actually 3 bills, but I'm sure you knew that, bans the Communist Party and the Chinese Communist government from buying land in the state of Florida. Not Chinese people. Then he goes on to make some jokes about DeSantis having token Asians around him. And here, in a stunning display of dishonesty, Stephen shows on the screen something quite interesting.
So the law, just to be clear, it bans Chinese, it bans them from purchasing land in Florida, right? So
yeah.
There's also legislation like this that's being considered in Texas.
Texas, oh, that's interesting. You really just showed that Florida thing really quickly and moved right past it, though. Let's rewind. What does that say? Who does this bill apply to?Only Chinese Communist Party members, right? Only people in the Chinese government, right? Because that's who you said you hate. And you explicitly said it doesn't ban Chinese people.
Some people are trying to frame it as though Chinese people, Chinese Americans. Nope.
Okay, not Chinese Americans and not Chinese people. Only Chinese Communist Party members and or Chinese government employees. But let's take a look at what the bill actually says right there on your screen. This ban applies to...any person who lives in China who is not a citizen or permanent resident of the U.S. In other words, Stephen, it applies to Chinese people. That's right. The bill bans Chinese people from buying property in Florida. This is how people know you hate Chinese people, because you're fighting against Chinese people. And by the way, there's a lot more you seem to intentionally not mention. For example, this part on your screen.That's right, this bill also bans any members of the other political parties in China. Good job, knuckleheads. You've just banned all the political parties, many of which have nothing to do with the big, bad, scary CCP. All of these hundreds of political parties all across China completely banned from Florida. Great job. And of course, the bill is not just about China, but also Russia, Venezuela, Syria, Iran, North Korea, and of course, the most dangerous country in the world by far, Cuba. And by the way, it also bans any non-American who lives in China, even if they aren't Chinese. So it's just a total contempt for China and Chinese people and the Chinese way of life. They're so repugnant that even being near them is reason enough to be banned. The other two bills, in case you're wondering, ban schools from basically any agreements with Chinese people, and other things like disallowing Florida government devices from installing apps owned by Chinese people. Goodbye, Reddit app! It also forces the government employees to uninstall and remove these kinds of apps. Since the term owned is never clarified in the sloppy bill, it could be interpreted to mean any Chinese ownership is applicable. Sorry, government employees, no more Spotify for you. General Electric, General Motors, AMC, the movie company, Reddit. And let's not forget the billions of learning Chinese apps made by those dastardly Chinese people. Get them off your phone. Anyway, so now that we've established that Steven Crowder says he hates just 10% of Chinese people, which is why he's supporting a bill that bans nearly 100% of Chinese people from buying land or doing business with schools in Florida, it all makes perfect sense if you just don't think about it. And of course, listen to Steven. You just need to hate more. Then it really does make sense. Now, this guy comes in with an interesting clarification, showing just the level of familiarity with China we're dealing with here.
But by the way, just let me make a quick point. This actually has caveats, right? So if you have dual citizenship, United States and Chinese, you can still buy land.
Well, considering there's no such thing as dual citizenship between the People's Republic of China and any other country, that would be quite a difficult and highly inflammatory and possibly illegal thing to add to a bill. That's why there's nothing at all in the bill about what you just said. Not at all. Try reading it.
Right. If you've been here for a certain period of time, you can still buy land. What they're trying to do is to make sure that the Chinese Communist Party can't come in and just buy up land, which is what they do around the world.
Right, so it stops Chinese nationals themselves, but it doesn't stop all Chinese. It doesn't stop any Americans,
no,
put it that way.
Not at all.
No Americans, no Chinese Americans. Stops, of course, the government of China and, of course, people who could be their proxies.
That's right. You just heard it here, folks. In the span of just a few minutes, this show went from promoting hate only against around 10% of Chinese people and claiming that this bill was only against them to downright admitting the only Chinese people this doesn't affect are U.S. citizens. Isn't it so interesting to see the right constantly trip up and accidentally admit their racial mindset? Think about it. This is a bill that bans cooperation with anyone living in China, no matter what their nationality or race is. And what Steven says here is, don't worry, Chinese Americans are not affected. It's the same thing that Bill Maher did back when I debunked his moronic pushing of the China virus term. This bill is very specific in who it targets. And those are people who live in China, even if they're French, Egyptian, or South African. This bill has nothing to do with race. This bill is not intrinsically racist. It's intrinsically Sinophobic. Now, we can get all meta and propose racism is at the foundation of Sinophobia or many other theories, but for the purposes of this bill is anti-Chinese people, not anti-ethnically or racially Chinese people. And yet, Stephen assures us that ethnically Chinese Americans are going to be fine. Stephen, who the hell brought up race? Why would ethnically Chinese Americans even be considered in this discussion? You are dragging this into a racial discussion. Then he goes on a rant in which he embarrassingly confuses the ideas of conservatism and libertarianism. And then he talks about that damn leftist media. Listen to this clip, which he tries to debunk, but ends up debunking himself instead.
You know what? People said that when the Japanese took over, you know, Pebble Beach, they bought Pebble Beach and they bought 30 Rock, that it was the end of the American century. And guess what?
Yes.
We survived it. You know what it's called? A free market, which again.
Right. We also survived when China bought a bunch of stuff in America. And that is the free market. If you want to buy things back from China, then go ahead. That's the free market. This dude is so far correct. To the degree that your market experiences state control is to the degree that we can also sloppily compare it to a socialist market. There are many different kinds of governments that control the market, including the US. But when we are speaking casually and imprecisely, we Americans do compare state control of the market with socialism. And that's what he's going to do right here.
Which again, Republicans are supposed to support free markets. Exactly. They're supposed to support free enterprise with Disney, with cruise lines, with small businesses. Like, this is about as overarching big government, socialist government as I've seen.
Okay, so this left-wing dude is adding 2 points. One, that Republicans should be in support of helping Disney, cruise lines, and small businesses. And that Republicans should be against the government dictating to schools and landowners which countries of origin they're not allowed to do business with. We don't have to agree with him, but his points are valid arguments. Let's see what Steven says to these.
First off, he's so stupid that he referred to Disney and cruise lines as small businesses.
Wow, he referred to Disney and cruise lines as small businesses, and that makes him so stupid. I mean, I guess the only person who could be even more stupid than that would be someone who listened to him speak, had an entire team helping him to write material about what he said, and still somehow didn't understand his simple sentence. Let's listen to what he said one more time.
Republicans are supposed to support free markets. Exactly. They're supposed to support free enterprise with Disney, with cruise lines, with small businesses.
They're supposed to support free enterprise with Disney, with cruise lines, with small businesses. Nope, he didn't call Disney or cruise line companies small businesses. He listed 3 things he thinks Republicans have been betraying: Disney, cruise lines, and small businesses. So, I mean, you're the one throwing around this stupid label, so right back at you. And after that embarrassing backfire, Stephen goes on to betray nearly every right-wing concept with a single incoherent ramble.
It's not a free market for American land to be purchased through potentially funds that have been gained through coercion, like with communism.
Yes, it is. That's exactly what makes a free market. What is this, some kind of gaslighting? All governments coerce taxes from their citizens, and those taxes are returned to market. Virtually all money ultimately stems from coercion. This argument is absolute drivel that doesn't stand up to even the slightest gust of wind of a pushback.
It's socialist big government to not allow communist governments to buy land in the United States? Did I miss something? Is there something I missed?
No. Yeah. You miss that socialist states believe in explicit state-controlled markets like the one this bill is helping to build. So the guy you are debunking has a very valid point. The bill you are supporting is anti-free market, and the free market is traditionally supported by libertarians, which you occasionally claim to be, though you seem confused about what those terms mean, so it's kind of unclear. Then this other guy chimes in with another quality hot take.
We can't buy land in China. They allow us no rights to buy land.
Right. That's because their market is state controlled, because they are a socialist state. They are further along the path of the bill that you are supporting. As I see people do so often, you are criticizing something while building towards becoming that thing. Then these guys ramble for a while about how China is uniquely dangerous and bad and scary. They also make several ridiculous anti-points about how the free market can't exist unless all sides are forced to participate in the same way, which is the underpinnings of much neocon pro-war activities. Then Stephen presents a bizarre anti-American rhetorical question.
How much land is too much when you think about the communist Chinese government and what their interests are? Do you think they care about you? Not only do they not care about you, they want what is worse for you.
Well, Stephen, there is no answer to how much land is too much land unless you have some kind of extra legal value judgment against Chinese people. Because again, this bill affects the Chinese people. In fact, given that around 10% of Chinese people are communists by your definitions, another way to say that is this bill is 90% against the Chinese people you love so much. So how much is too much? There is no answer unless we as Americans form regulations and laws protecting our land from being sold to companies or persons from other countries. Now, that's basically the definition of xenophobic. But still, it's probably a good idea to have limitations on what percent of your country can be owned by non-citizens. I mean, at least I'm open to discuss it. And logically, that seems to be what you're proposing. You know which country already did that? That's right. The country you have just attacked for having done that. China. Oh, and here we go. The sidekick guy makes my point for me.
Yeah.
There's 17 other countries that have more land in the United States than does China. We're picking on China because of the Chinese Communist Party, the Communist
I don't want Canada to buy land either. But
I don't either.
Right. So we all agree then. We Americans should at least discuss limiting how much of our country should be owned by non-nationals. And I guess we can send a sorry postcard to China for the bashing you just gave them for doing the thing that you're pushing for now. Has anyone ever questioned you guys on this stuff? It's seeming quite lazily dreamt up. They kind of go on and on about this because it's a live show, so they need to kind of milk the subject. But I've addressed their main points, and this is one reason I don't often watch these types of videos anymore. They're just so ill-conceived, juvenile, and rudimentary. It's almost boring for me to debunk these kinds of things because they're just, I mean, a baby could see through this garbage. But if you want me to keep doing these types of debunks, and just let me know and I shall slave away for you. The truth is America can and probably should do whatever it takes to secure its future. But whatever we do, we need to be honest about why we're doing it. The reason we're banning Chinese people from doing various kinds of business in Florida, including owning land, has nothing to do with communism. I'm not even sure if you guys understand what communism is, the way you use the term. A more adept person than I might suggest the real reason for this anti-China virtue signal is as a suck-up to Florida businesses and investors who hate the free market because it invites unwelcome competition from those maniacal, wealthy Chinese. But I'm not that astute. I'm just a random idiot out in the world questioning things just a little bit more than most. Until next time, I'm Nathan Rich. Thanks, everybody. See ya.